wet laid on mortar and then grouted when it's set a bit.
Hello.
Jemaine, how are you?
Who's that?
Hello.
Hi, Helen. Oh, where are you? On the boundary wall.
Fine, overlooking. Beautiful. Beautiful.
I'm laying the brick pavers on dry, firm sand.
Alan, yeah. It's party time, so come now when you're ready, then, OK?
Cynthia, I am so strapped. Can you bring me a plate of something over?
I certainly will, yeah.
Here,
no time to stop laying herringbone. Sandwiching in the pieces. Having some bricks neatly chopped before stuffing them in, filling every corner, forcing them in chock-a-block.
All ready, sir?
Good Lord, anyone want a snack?
All right, Al?
Finally, filling any remaining gaps with kiln-dried sand.
Wish us luck, because we don't half need it. It's 2:15. We're all ever so tired and quite a bit wet, and it's gone quite quiet here. I'd love to meet all those people who say, well, you always finish. I wish I knew how little confidence we often have. Anyway, no time for all that rubbish now. Let's get on.
Good job, Mr. T. We'll make a pro out of him yet. Oh.
Time had a rest from this brick lay. Plants.
And it's
only just. Just got around to them. 5:05. But it's great using a lot of foliage with things like these plum-coloured engineering bricks and then these wonderful pavers. Charlie's planting this fatsia, this false castor oil, which is a bold evergreen, quite tough. And there's a wonderful purple-leaved heuchera there. This one's called plum pudding. Really plummy coloured, with ruffle-edged leaves. And we're planting it here with thymes, which will creep and be wonderfully aromatic when bruised. These delicious ornamental grasses by the name of nacella, and a spiky white astilbe. It's a great corner there, a mixture of flower, but mainly foliage, texture and colour. Back to my brick lane.
Now, tell me what's wrong with this border.
There's absolutely nothing wrong with that border.
Sure.
It's very much overstuffed, but I think that's rather good for effect. But it's good. It's beginning to look like a garden, don't it? Charlie, tell me when you're ready for me to screw that gargoyle on, because I'm standing here like a coiled sponge.
You can do it now. It's not a problem, so I can get the hose up through the back. Get
right.
It, can't I?
Yep.
So I do want to get it like that, though. So that it covers that, so that right. Means...
Hello.
Jack.
Hiya.
Hiya, how are you?
Yes, fine. How have you gone?
Oh, it's great. We had a lovely couple of days.
Yeah, brilliant. So you're on your way home, yeah?
Yeah, we've just come in from a place called Cross Arms in Carmarthen. It's a big busy woman.
How long will you be home? Can I get food ready?
Yeah, it'd be great. It's, more than I could imagine, about an hour.
About an hour's drive, is it? Or is something on then for you?
Oh, great.
Okay then. Safe journey then. I'll go get some dinner on.
Okay, see you later.
Okay, ta-ra then.
Ta-ra
then. Bye. An hour.
An hour, and it's 5:05. I'm going to reckon really on about 3/4 of an hour from now.
Really?
for about half an hour.
Is it on?
Oh, it's heavy, isn't it?
It is very heavy. That's why I asked you. Ace, wonderful.
I think I better get that changed.
Right, I wish I could. Quick. Come on, out, round here. They're coming through that way. This way. Put your bucket down over there. Do you think we're going to feed Paddy Double Cream for doing this?
Why are they standing to attention?
Years ago, remember that patch where you said you'd like a water feature? Remember?
Yeah.
The water feature and the bricks. Well, what do you think of that?
My God. Oh, my God. That's fantastic.
Oh, look at Grandpa's.
Hello.
Oh,
how are you?
Tommy, you're done. I knew you were big.
How are you?
Oh, that's fantastic. Oh, that's really nice.
You mustn't walk on the blue bricks.
Any colour you like except blue, Kevin. Just don't walk on the blue tonight.
Oh, that's
the red and the rest you can go on.
Oh, and a water feature as well.
We were told.
Oh, that's terrific.
We always do what we're told, but sometimes we allow our imaginations a little space too. Visual treats now fill this tiny corner, adding a wealth of interest where once there was none. Using different types of bricks breaks up the corner's rigid geometry, and there's plenty of vigorous planting here. Soon, the vine will be clothing the roof of the pergola, softening it and shading the seats below. This is a corner complete, but only just.
Oh, that's absolutely brilliant.
Take your missus and go and have a sit in your chair.
Don't step on the
blue one.
Ah, oh, that's absolutely brilliant. Can we open our champagne?
And she kept the secret all the time, didn't you? Well done, Kate.
Don't wet that paving.
Oh, this is great.
Well, thanks very much for this. This is marvellous.
Turn around that way and say, from the Ground Force team until next time, ta-ra.
From the Ground Force team till next week, ta-ra.
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 Wonderful.
It's beautiful, really nice.
Will you get time to sit out here?
Yeah, we'd have McTelly in the evenings, you know. Among all the gnats.
Yeah, we've discovered the midges, you know.
Lovely. Cheers.
Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you.
Enjoy it at the end of your meal, friend.
Thanks a lot.
For a booklet on the gardens in Series 6, send a £2 cheque or postal order to Ground Force 6, PO Box 1001, Manchester M60 3JB.
And with a range of projects, Tommy helps you give your garden the Ground Force touch in this new BBC book. And Alan's back in Gardener's World on BBC Two now.
Hello, it's Steve Wright in the afternoon, live till 5 in the big Radio 2 studio. With us today, we've got Mr. Charm himself, Pierce Brosnan. And now, here's another.
Emma played Cupid.
May I present Miss Smith?
She's a very good...